the main inspiration was hearing another writer on the radio saying, oh, every Calgary writer has a stampede story. And I thought, I don't. But it filtered away for years. It's a way to play on nostalgia and people's good feelings and then work with that in a story, in a disruptive way. It's a 13-year-old girl, Wendy, who goes to the Stampede Grounds with her family, and that would be her mom and her dad and her older brother, who's like an adult. And then she gets a crush on a dancer that's on the midway and looks to ditch her family and succeeds in ditching her family and has a get-together with the dancer.
Well, I came out with a sense of a cautionary tale. Like, to me, it was a very strong, like, an urban cautionary tale, and it wasn't necessarily, like, usually it's a folk tale depicting something in the woods. For me, it was an urban tale. For me, there was a lot of backstory to everything. Sense of fate, a sense of destiny, sense of something that sometimes things are beyond your power. There might be something else conjuring in the background, and also like very strong the two the friends for me, they were not necessarily friends. I could sense this sort of like a competition between them.
I hadn't really thought through that maybe they were not great friends, or that, you know, maybe girls that age weren't that great friends, although there's all sorts of books written on that, that they were kind of mean girls. Mm-hmm. I hadn't thought through that part, so it was great to see the image you made of them, because then I was like, oh, oh yeah, totally, they are part of the issue here.
And I consider this as a story that was, you know, when you return to school, the next, I guess she would have been a freshman or something. And what did you do for your summer vacation? And so that's why it's in the form of a scrapbook. And then it's tied up with boot laces, as if it was cowboy hiking boots or something. It's interesting the way that they paired us together, because mm-hmm. I consider myself a magic realist, expressionist magic realist painter or printer. And I don't think the people necessarily are that familiar with my work, so it's interesting that they cottoned on to that.
Yeah. Like, so. I write a lot of magic realism, but not this story. So this is just total realism, kitchen sink realism going on here. Yeah, so that is interesting.
Yeah.
I was surprised by how much the work was, like I've heard my writing described as Alberta Gothic. I don't even really know what that is, but I would say the drawing has a Gothic, Sally's work has a Gothic aspect to it, like that, how that worked together for a stampede story. Yeah.